In this presentation, we'll look at the basic settings for SAP Finance. In SAP Financial Accounting, the client is the highest node in the system. The client is usually defined by a 3-digit code. And you can find the client when you actually first log into SAP. It will be there in the main screen. For example, the client on this screenshot is 100. So the client is like an independent unit, and in that unit, it is the highest node for any module. You'll need to create your master data and transition data separately in each client. However, the configurations can be moved from one client to another client. Now we'll be looking at all these terminologies in the next slide in more detail. What is master data? Master data means it's a common data stored in the system, and it can be used by many different systems, and it can be used indefinitely. Let me give an example. You have a vendor where you buy your phones and you make your phone mobile plans and you pay your bills. So that vendor, we give for example, is Vodafone. So you create the master data for Vodafone. So you give the Vodafone company details, their address, their contact, that's your email, telephone numbers. What are the payment terms? Payment terms mean like for within how many days you need to make the payment from the invoice bill. The bank details or the credit card details, all the details, you can key in the master data. Then you have the transactional data. So transaction data, just like its description, it uses the master data in its transactions. For example, when you buy a phone from Vodafone, it becomes a transaction. It's a purchasing an item, so that becomes a transaction. When you make a monthly payment, that's another transaction. So all these transactions are called transactional data. And all these transactions are relevant to a master data, which is Vodafone. So master data is just a common data giving all the information of the company or vendor or customer, a GL account, an asset, anything. And the transaction data uses the master data in its transactions. Let's look at configuration. Now this is the main SAP menu path for your configurations. SAP comes with pre-built with a lot of standard settings. But however, you need to specifically configure based on your company's needs. For example, you have to set up your company in SAP with the company code and your company details. You have to set up your bank account in SAP. You have to set up your chart of accounts, your general ledger structure, all your assets, accounts payables, accounts receivable. All these settings have to be set up in SAP. And this is called the configuration. And like we saw earlier, configuration settings can be moved from one client to another client. So how does it move? Every time you do a configuration, it generates something called a transport request. It's a unique number given by SAP. Every time you can have different transport request numbers, or you can just have one transport request number. And this transport request number will identify what is the configuration you did. For example, if you create a company code, you can link it to a transport request number and give the description of creation of company code. That is the transport request. Let's look at the clients and servers. Usually in an SAP implementation, you will have three different servers. The development server, the quality assurance server, and the production server. The development server is where you do all your configurations. So this is where you come and first set up the system. And you can have different clients inside one server. For example, development server, I can have a client as 100 for configuration and 110 for unit testing. So unit testing is the testing which you do after you do the configuration to make sure the system works. Then after that, you can release the configuration to a quality assurance server, or you call it the quality testing server. And in this server, the users can do the testing. And you can also carry out training in this server. And if everything passes, then you can release it to the main live system, call it the production server. So that's the purpose. You have three different servers, one to do all your configurations, another one to do your testing, and the final one is your live system. So you actually prevent doing any testing or any configuration directly in the live system, because you do not want to disrupt the normal proceedings. That's why you have the three different servers. Now let's look at a company code. The company code is the most important organizational unit in financial accounting. The company code is an independent legal entity, which means if you register a public limited or proprietary limited or private limited company with your country's taxation office, then in the system you must create as a company code. Your financial statements, that is your balance sheet statements, and your P&L or income statements, cash flow statements, these are all created at a company code level. In SAP, the company code is identified by a 4-character code. It can be alphanumeric. In this example, the company code is 1000. And then you can give a company name for this. Along with that, you also provide the address of the company, the currency it uses, and the language. So these are all important qualities of the company code in SAP. Let's look at a fiscal year. The company's fiscal year is their calendar year for financial reporting. For example, if it's an Australian company, it will follow Australia's fiscal year or financial year, which starts from 1st of July to 30th of June every year. Similarly, for a US-based company, it will follow USA's fiscal year, which starts from 1st of October to 30th of September. In the SAP environment, the terminology period is most commonly used rather than month. So you have your calendar month and then it's converted to a period. For example, if you are in Australia, your fiscal year starts from July to June. So July is your period 1, August is your period 2, and all the way in June is your period 12. And that is a link between your calendar month and period. And this is derived from your country's financial year. And there is a configuration setting which has been done at the back end, and the financial year has been assigned to your company code. So whenever you do a financial posting, you just specify the standard dates and the system will automatically derive what is the relevant period. Now let's look at currencies. A company will have to use many different currencies, especially when it deals with foreign customers and vendors. Hence, it is very important to maintain the exchange rates in the system. There are some exchange rate types which you can maintain in the system. For example, the bank buying rate, the bank selling rate. These you can get from your federal or central banks. And then the most commonly used in SAP is the average rate, which is the median rate, denoted by the letter M. That is the average of the bank buying rate and the bank selling rate. For example, if your country's bank buying rate for that particular date from 1 euro to 1 US dollars is 1.10 cents, and your bank selling rate is 1 euro to US dollars is 1.20 cents, then you can use the average rate, which is the average of these two, that is 1 euro is equal to 1.15 US dollars. You can enter the foreign currency exchange rates in this SAP environment using the transaction code F-62. You usually enter it at the average rate with the letter M, specify a date, and mention what conversion you're using. For example, 1 Australian dollar is equal to 0.75 US dollars. This setting applies to the whole client. So once you enter this in the system for this particular date, it applies to all the company codes in this SAP environment. This makes it very easy for global and multinational companies where they do not have to maintain the exchange rate at each company code level. Rather, they are directly maintained at the client level, and it applies to all the companies around the world. Now let's see how we can maintain this exchange rate in the system. So let's use the transaction code F-62, press enter to continue, click on, and you can see already so many entries have been maintained in the system. Click on new entries, exchange rate type, we will use that M, which is the average rate. Specify the date you're going to enter it for, which is valid for that current date or any date you have got the exchange rate. So I'm just going to specify a current date. Then mention that what I'm going to convert from, for example, from AUD to USD. And you need to say that, okay, from 1 AUD, so you don't have to put 1. But how much is 1 AUD is equal to USD? So for example, I have got my exchange rate as 1 AUD is equal to 0.7659 US dollars. So I'm just going to press enter. And automatically puts in that ratio from 1 to 1. So now we have put the date. For this particular date, the average rate from 1 Australian dollars is equal to 0.7659 US dollars. And then just save the transaction. Now for your assignment, find out your country's fiscal year. If you're not in the country listed, as I showed in my example over here, if you're in a different country, just Google your country's name and just type in fiscal year, and you should get some information with regard to from which month to which month your fiscal year is for that particular country. Then Google some exchange rates for your country's currency. For example, in my previous slide, I showed you how to maintain from Australian dollars to US dollars, and whatever country you're in, just find out the exchange rate for some hard currencies. And then use the transaction code F-62 to update the exchange rate in the system.